Hi, my name is John Remolio Petal-Corin. I am the Director for Advocacy of the Moro National Liberation Front, or MNLF. Question. Sir John, are MILF and MNLF camps a sanctuary for criminals? Answer. First and foremost, you should know that MNLF is not an organization that is exclusive for those who embrace the Islamic faith. MNLF is composed of Muslims, Christians, tribal Lumads, and any other religions. So when we talk about MNLF, whether it be territory or camp, you must understand that it has all kinds of religions in it, and they live in religious tolerance and harmony under the egalitarian ideology of MNLF. Christians respect Islamic practices in MNLF territories and vice versa. Religion is never a cause of neighbor-to-neighbor conflict in any MNLF community. On the other hand, you should know that the MILF is an exclusive Islamic organization. When we talk about MILF territories or camps, you must expect that it is exclusive for Muslims. Now that you know the basics, I am ready to answer your question about whether MILF and MNLF camps are sanctuaries for criminals. I will answer that within the context of Islamic culture called Hijrah. In Islam, sanctuary or asylum is a right of anyone seeking protection. Asylum are being provided without being discrimination by free persons or those who are enslaved, whether rich or poor, men and women, or Muslims and non-Muslims. Granting asylum is also a duty of the political leaders of Islamic communities. Muslim leaders are obliged to provide sanctuary to anyone who seeks it indiscriminately and unconditionally. Sharia law says that when an Islamic community finds it difficult or impossible to grant protection to an asylum seeker at the place where he or she seeks asylum, another refuge should be found in another Islamic community. A person who has been granted protection cannot be attacked after asylum is granted. His or her life, property, and freedom are safeguarded. Muslims also provide asylum to non-Muslims. An asylum beneficiary is not obliged to follow Islamic rites and rituals or become a Muslim. He or she is free to follow his or her religious practices during the period of temporary asylum or refuge. The protection status is temporary. Historically, refuge was granted for a period of 1 year. After that, the refugees are expected to leave their place of refuge, seek another place of refuge, return home, or become a permanent member of the Islamic community. Muslims believe that asylum is an obligation that must be granted to people who seek for it, especially when the seeker comes from places where there is injustice, intolerance, physical persecution, diseases, and even financial insecurity and poverty. Excluded from Hijrah are criminals who, whenever granted asylum by Islamic communities, were made to voluntarily surrender and face the justice system later on. However, when the Philippine court issues arrest warrant to a person as a result of baseless allegations, it will surely be difficult for Philippine authorities to arrest the person, especially if the members of the Muslim community where that person resides are personally and directly aware that a person is innocent. For example, when the community is knowledgeable of his innocence because they are personally with him during the recorded time of crime was committed somewhere else. Falsely charged individuals are given sanctuary and asylum is in Muslim communities of MILF as well as MNLF. Thank you.